to Church of Pentecost TV channel. I believe that our previous relationship with you through our former messages were interesting to you, and that is why you have joined us today once again. In the midst of this calamity, this pandemic, I think what everybody is looking out to hear is good news. And so in our previous messages, we talked about our basic belief in God, his message, his word. And we looked at an aspect of his ability to relate to humanity, to relate to people. And so today we are going to look at that aspect of God's relationship with you and with me. And I have termed or given the theme of the message, the good news message. The good news message. And so I'm going to read a portion of scripture to you, and we will see what God wants to tell us through this passage. I'm reading Romans chapter 1, verse 15 through to 17. So I am eager to come to you in Rome too, to preach the good news, for I am not ashamed of this good news about Christ. It is the power of God at work, saving everyone who believes, the Jew first and also the Gentile. 17. This good news tells us how God makes us right in his sight. This is accomplished from the start to finish by faith. As the scriptures say, it is through faith that a righteous person has life. Now, for us to be able to know the basics or the background of this message or passage, we need to look at the writer of the book. The writer of the book by name Saul, who later became Paul. Saul, in Acts chapter 9, we are made known that he was somebody who was a diehard, you know, Pharisee. He was in a religion of Judaism, and a very diehard one, a Pharisee. And when he saw that the disciples of Jesus Christ were spreading the good news or their message, he stood against it. He organized people to stand against it, and through that, Stephen, one of the disciples of Jesus Christ, was killed. He was the first martyr for the Christian religion. And so, having done that, it brought persecution in Jerusalem. And that persecution drove many of the Christians out of Jerusalem. And some of them ended up in various cities and towns. And for him to be able to carry out his murderous task, he went and sought for permission, got a letter of accreditation in order to be able to go and pursue the believers who have traveled to other places, who have fled Jerusalem to other places. And so, after getting this authority to go and chase the believers, Paul, or Saul, according to Acts chapter 9, was going to Damascus, where many of the believers were residing. On his way to Damascus, he met Jesus. He met the risen Lord, Jesus Christ. And that encounter caused him to be blind. And God instructed him that he had chosen him to preach the gospel or the good news. And then he was also directed to go into a place where a man called Ananias will come and pray for him. And all these things happened as the Lord have said it. Now, he was the one who wrote this, you know, letter or this message to the Romans. After he has preached, going to many places as a missionary, establishing churches and nurturing them and growing them, he eventually began to write letters to these places. And so in the course of doing that, he wanted to, you know, go to Rome, where some of the believers were and the churches had been established. But he could not have the time to go there, and so he wrote this letter to the people of Rome. Now, from the first verse of the book of Romans, we see that he describes himself as a slave of Christ, a slave of Christ. And he was somebody who has been chosen by God to be an apostle who will preach the good news to people. According to Acts chapter 9 verse 16, we see that when he met Jesus, the voice that spoke to him was that he has been chosen to go and preach the same message that he was, you know, standing against. And so Paul is making emphasis here that he is a chosen vessel, an apostle of Jesus Christ, to preach the good news. From verse 2, we also learn that God has made promise of this good news through the Holy Scriptures, through his prophets. God has made promises that this good news is going to be preached unto all humanity through the forefathers, through the prophets of the Old Testament, Bible. And we come to the third verse of the Romans chapter 1, and here we see that the good news was all about Jesus, who is the Son of God. The good news that Apostle Paul is preaching, that has been prophesied, it was all about the Son of God. It was not about any, philosophy, about anything else, any theory, any principle, but it was all about his Son, that is the Son of God, Jesus Christ. Now, Jesus was shown to be the Son of God by being raised from the dead. That is the fourth verse. The fourth verse let us know that Jesus Christ, by being raised by the Holy Spirit, by the power of God, is the emphasis, the confirmation that he was the Son of God. And verse 5 also tells us that through Christ, we have the privilege to tell other people, to tell all people, that God has done something amazing, something supernatural, something awesome. And so we are given that privilege, we are given that task to go and preach this good news to people so that they will believe and obey. Apostle Paul was saying that he has been given that task, and that is also the task for everyone who is a Christian leader, who is a believer. We are all called to send out the message of the good news. And so, in a nutshell, these were the beginning or the introduction of his letter. But let us jump to the verse 15, 16, and 17 that we read. It's the Apostle Paul says that he is eager to come and preach the good news to the people that were in Rome. In this time of the pandemic, in this time that people are looking for salvation from all angles, during this time that people don't know what to do, I think that the best thing that we can bring to your homes, bring to your families, bring to your life is the good news of the gospel of God. And so we have taken it upon ourselves to bring you this good news so that in this time of perplexity, you might have hope in the hopeless situation. And it goes on in verse 16 and says, "For I am not ashamed of the gospel, because it is the power of God for salvation to everyone who believes." The gospel, the good news, the good news that is about Jesus Christ, it is the power of God unto salvation for everyone who believes. And in verse 17, he says that the good news tells us how God made us right in his own sight through faith. The good news is not about what we can do or what we are about to do or what we have done, but it is the power of God that is brought to us through Jesus Christ, so that when we believe, when we have faith in Jesus Christ, it is equated unto us for righteousness and for salvation. And so what can we learn about this? What can we learn from this passage? You see, the good news or the gospel revolves around three important things. And the three important things, we can find them in 1 Corinthians chapter 15 from verse 3, 4, and 5. Or if you like, we may go back to verse 2 to 4. 1 Corinthians chapter 15. When we read from verse 2, 3, and 4, it says, "It is the good news that saves you if you continue to believe in the message I told you." This is Apostle Paul once again speaking. "Unless, of course, you believed in something that was never true in the first place." Verse 3, "I passed on to you what was most important and what had also been passed on to me." Listen carefully. "Christ died for our sins, just as the scripture said. He was buried, and he was raised from the dead on the third day, just as the scripture said. He was seen by Peter and then by the 12. We will end there. So the good news that Apostle Paul is saying here, the message that he is talking about here, revolves around these three things. First of all, Christ died for our sins. And that is according to the scriptures. It is not his opinion. It is not his suggestion. It is not his supposition. It is not something that he was suggesting. But it is based and stemmed from the Holy Scriptures. Christ died for our sins. Now, let me make emphasis on the death of Christ as the first point that our salvation revolves around, that the good news revolves around. You see, John 1:29 says that Jesus Christ is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. The sins of the world. How did the world plunge into sin? How can the world be called the sins of the world? How can people be, you know, said to be sinners? It is because Adam and Eve, our forefathers, made a mistake of disobeying God, the only single commandment that God gave them. They had access to everything that was in the Garden of Eden, but they didn't have access to that tree of knowledge of good and of evil. God forbade them not to touch it. But by making that mistake, it severed their relationship with God. It broke off their relationship with God. And that brought about death. Because God is, you know, eternal. And as long as the Adam and Eve had a relationship with God, they were, or they would have lived eternally. But the moment that they broke off relationship with God, it brought about sin and death. Now, death is the evidence of sin in the world. And so the Bible says anyone who will die, it is a symbol that that person is under the condemnation of sin. And so the world needed a pardon. The world needed somebody who would pardon our sins. And that is why God sent his Son. This is how God is relating to us. That omnipotent God, that all-powerful God, he is relating to us by sending his only begotten Son to us. The Bible says that Jesus has not come to condemn us. He did not come to judge us. He did not come to say and do anything, but to save us, to show us the way of salvation. And so that is what the death of Jesus Christ means to you and me. Galatians 1:4 says that Jesus gave himself up for our sins to rescue us from the evil of the world. He gave himself as a ransom, as a gift for you and for me. Isaiah 53, 3 says that he was despised for our sake. And 1 Peter 2:24 says that he carried our sins. Beloved, I want to finish this, you know, session here. We will continue. But I want you to think hard about the message of the gospel, the good news. God brought his son Jesus Christ to you and to me to come and die for you and for me. He died as a pardon. He died in our stead. We were supposed to die. We were supposed to suffer the consequences of the sins of our forefather Adam and Eve. But by God's unfailing grace, his mercy, that is all encompassing mercy. That is a mercy that covers everything. He overlooked our sins, he overlooked our wrongdoings, overlooked everything that we did, and has given us his son Jesus Christ. He beckoned us to come to him. And when we have come to Jesus, beloved, we have salvation through him, through faith. We have eternal hope through him, through faith. And so as this message comes to an end, it is my prayer that you will surrender yourself to Jesus Christ. And if you have Jesus, the Bible says, he that is in us is greater than he that is in the world. Irrespective of whatever will happen, you have eternal hope. May God bless you. May he shine his face towards you. In Jesus' name, amen.